evaluate the definite integral of x over x square plus 3 quantity square with respect to x from 1 to 2. Okay, we got a fraction. There is no fraction rule, so we just ignore the limits for time being. That means we consider the indefinite integral. Let I be the indefinite integral, the corresponding without limits, x over quantity x square plus 3 square dx with respect to x. Now we want to find this integral first, and later we go back and evaluate at the upper limit 2 minus lower limit 1. Okay, let's work on this. This is a fraction. There is no fraction rule, so we need to make a substitution, generally the inside function or in the bottom. So in this case, this is inside function x square plus 3, so this will be our u. So let u be x square plus 3. Now we want to convert everything in terms of u, so we need to convert dx as well. So to get dx from this assumption, we want to differentiate both sides with respect to x. So derivative of u, that means du over dx, is equal to derivative of x square is 2x plus derivative of 3 is 0, plus 0 not needed. Now from this we want to isolate dx. For we do something similar to cross multiplication. So du equals 2x dx. Now divide by 2x, then dx is isolated. So dx equals divide by 2x. So du over 2x. Okay. With these substitutions, this indefinite integral is now, we have nothing for x over x squared plus 3 is u squared. Now dx is found to be du over 2x. Okay, so x and dx on the top and bottom, now we can cancel. Okay, this x was given so that we can do this integral, by the way. This 2 on the bottom, constant, can be pulled outside, so 1/2. So 1 over u squared, which is same as, move this to the top now, u to the negative 2 du. Now we can use the power rule. It's like when we have xn with respect to x, that is xn plus 1 over n plus 1, as long as the bottom is not 0. So n is not equal to negative 1. It's not negative 1, so we can use this rule. Here our variable is u. Okay, so this is times u, n plus 1, negative 2 plus 1, negative 1 divided by same number. Plus c is not needed in this case, because eventually we're going to work with these lower limits and upper limits. Now let's simplify. Negative 1 pulled to the all the way front, so negative 1/2, this negative to the front, u raised to negative 1 is same as 1 over u. So this is negative 1 times 1 over 2u. Okay, and we need to back substitute the value of u. Negative 1 over 1 over 2 u is x squared plus 3. To complete this question, now we need to evaluate at the upper limit and lower limit. So this indefinite integral, so our limits were 1 through 2. So 1 through 2. So we replace x by 2. That's the upper limit part, minus replace x by lower limit 1. So that's, or we could have written negative 1/2 all the way out for both, same thing. So negative 1 over 2, this x is now 2, so 2 is squared, that's 4 plus 3, 7. So 2 times 7, which is 14, minus lower limit 1. So negative 1/2, and 1 is square is 1 plus 3, 4. Okay, so this is negative 1 over 2 times 7, 14. Negative, negative, positive, 1 over 8. Okay, now we need to combine these two fractions. Okay, we should have 1/2, 1/2 factor out all the way. Anyways, so we need to work on common denominator. Okay, look at here, 2 and 2, those are the common factors. 7 and 4 are relatively prime, so we need to multiply. This is 1 over 7, we have 1 over 7, so multiply this by 7 over 7 and multiply this by 4 over 4, so that 14 times 4 56, 8 times 7 56, that's the common denominator. So now 56 on the top, negative 1 times 4 is negative 4, plus 1 times 7 is 7, 7 minus 4 is 3 over 56. That's the final answer.